नम्रता, शुड वी स्टार्ट?
And apart from that, we see in Mahabharat when Draupadi is being stripped in public, right? She's humiliated.
Yeah.
It's Krishna who comes to the rescue. When Dushasan is taking off her sari, Krishna goes on adding layers to her sari. So that way her sari never ends. And you'll notice that we have always heard about two Krishnas, right? One who is in Mahabharat, the one who is in battleground, and the one who is in Vrindavan, chasing the gopiyas, stealing their clothes, stealing makhan. It's the classic transition. And you'll see they both are very different, even though they are the same person, right? In Vrindavan, he plays the flute. He's very playful. He's very naughty. He takes part in the Rangabhumi, the circle of dance. But in Mahabharat, you see a very different Krishna. He's a politician, he's a statesman, he's a kingmaker. He's Dwarkadhish. He's serious, he's always in the move. He's killing people, he's very staunch. And you see, he does not carry a flute. He is always in his armor, and he's always with his chakra, Sudarshan chakra.
And he's carrying bows and arrow?
Yeah. And he takes part in Ranbhumi, the battleground, not the Rangbhumi. The transition happens when Krishna is leaving Vrindavan forever. He leaves Vrindavan to fulfill the prophecy of killing his uncle, Kansa, in Mathura. That's where he starts growing up, becoming the next Krishna. Mahabharat focuses on the adult life of Krishna, whereas you see Srimad Bhagavatam, it focuses on his childhood and his domestic life with his wife's mom.
When we talk about Krishna, it is mandatory that Radha is going to come next. What do you have to say about Radha?
So Radha is a very controversial topic, because you will not find Radha's mention in Mahabharat or Srimad Bhagavatam or Vishnu Puran. You will not find her mentioned. In Srimad Bhagavatam, Radha is mentioned, but in a spiritual context, and it's very indirect. It's not in association to Lord Krishna. But we really hear about Radha. We see Radha's mention in Jayadev's Geet Govind, where Krishna's relationship with his gopiyas, especially Radha, is written.
Why did Radha Krishna not marry?
So there are many potential answers to this question, and I have been asked this question twice before. So first of all, let's state the facts. Radha and Krishna were cursed by Sridhama. Sridhama was a very big devotee of Lord Krishna, and he could not tolerate Radha, because he saw that Sri Krishna was giving more importance to prem than bhakti devotion. So he was very jealous. So he cursed Radha that you will lose your memory of Lord Krishna and you'll stay away from him for 100 years. So when Lord Krishna and Radha come a descent to earth, Radha Rani has no memory of their past life in Golok. So as per the curse, Sri Krishna and Radha had to stay away from each other. Other than that, you see, there was a big devotee of Lord Vishnu who asked him for a wish that he wants goddess Lakshmi as his wife. So as per the norm, Lord Vishnu had to fulfill this wish. This avatar was Lord Krishna's, and the devotee was born as Ayan, who is Radharani's childhood friend, and she was betrothed to him. So I've also read that when Lord Vishnu descended as Krishna, goddess Lakshmi descended as Radha, Rukmini and Satyabhama. So even though Radha was not his wife, he was still with Lakshmi, as Rukmini and Satyabhama were his wives. The third reason, in some folklores, Radha is said to be Krishna's aunt, mommy, like Krishna's father's sister. So you know, you have to abide by the societal norm. You can't just marry your own family. But the most important reason, I think, is let's contemplate on the question, right? What is marriage and what is love? Marriage is a bandhan, right? And love is a bhav, a emotion. And when bhav and bandhan comes together, it becomes very strong. But if you read Radha Krishna's story, you will understand that these two lovers, they were beyond this earthly life. Their love was more spiritual. It was more about a devotion. So you didn't really need these two to marry. So you see, you can't bind Radha Krishna in a particular bond. You can't name them as a friends or girlfriend or boyfriend or best friend. There exists no bond between them but of love. So it's, think it like this, if they had been married, do you think their love story would be as special as it is now, right? And I think it's the modern fairy tale generation which has spoon fed us this fact, right? That love that leads to domestic life, marriage is the only happily ever after, which is a very narrow thinking, I think. Fun fact, although Radha Krishna didn't marry on earth, they had a celestial wedding, a Brahma Viva, where Lord Brahma himself conducted their wedding rituals. So you see, although they were not together on earth, they are eternally together in the spiritual world.
Namrata, thanks for such an enriching session. Guys, that was the last episode of Conversations with My Sister. This is a wrap up with the topic Shri Krishna. Hope you guys have been enjoying these conversations. So Namrata, how was it for you? How was shooting a vlog? How does it feel like seeing yourself on YouTube every day?
Oh my God, it feels so unreal. Trust me, it's like every day I'm aware that I'm uploading the vlog and uploading the story. I'm like, how did we come to this? Thanks to the lockdown.
And what do you think? Do you think that now you're confident enough? Do you think you can make videos of your own or talk to people through social media?
I think I'll give that to you. Thanks for making me confident. I think now if somebody from the blue team asks me to be a part of the debate, I would.
Anything else you would like to add and, you know, say as the last end note?
ज़्यादा कुछ नहीं, बस यही कहूँगी, प्रेम से बोलो राधे राधे. If you like my Freaka Gyan, you can find me on Instagram. My Instagram handle is Namru is Asli. मैं ये सब content post नहीं करती, लेकिन मैं memes बहुत share करती हूँ. I'm a pretty cool person. If you like this video, be sure to hit the like button, click on the subscribe button, and अगर comment भी कर दो कि तो मुझे और मेरे दिल को बहुत अच्छा लगेगा. I take my farewell. Bye bye.